I'm Ratna Bhushan, a friend motivator and guide to IESS Sprint, international motivational speaker, leadership trainer, CEO, coach, political strategist and policy advisor, a comprehensive current for dedicated student. Listening is very powerful. The quote of today is, to forget how to dig the earth, to forget how to dig the earth and tend the soil is to forget ourselves. This quote by Mahatma Gandhi, from the book, The Words of Gandhi by Richard by Attenborough. Before starting the program, I would like to request you kindly please share, subscribe and like. Please share, subscribe and like. इस वीडियो को फैलाने में मेरी मदद करें, बस एक मिनट दें, आपसे मुझे बहुत इंकरेजमेंट मिलता है, आपसे छोटे से प्रयास से लाखों करोड़ों लोगों को फायदा पहुंचेगा. न्यूज़ जानना हर व्यक्ति की आवश्यकता है. सो द सोर्स इज द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर. लिसनिंग इज वेरी पावरफुल. इंडिया टू टेक कॉल ऑन द ऑस्ट्रेलियाज इंक्लूजन इन मालाबार एक्सरसाइजेस. Decision at Defence Ministry meeting early next week. India will take a decision on whether to include Australia in the Malabar exercise with Japan and US at the Defence Ministry meeting early next week, according to a defence source. The decision, if taken, could bring all Quad countries together as part of the annual war games. The general consensus is that Australia should join. A discussion of going to happen in the Defence Ministry on this issue next week. The defence source said on the condition of anonymity. LSE standoff. As reported by the Hindu, on June 3rd, after the use of the reluctance, India said it was open to Australia inclusion in Malabar as an observer. The move comes in the midst of ongoing standoff with China on the border, the biggest crisis on a line of actual control, LSE. In over 5 decades, Australia's inclusion would be seen as possible as first step towards the militarization of the Quad coalition, something Beijing has opposed in the post. Once the government takes a decision to include Australia as per the procedure, the other partner nations, Japan and US, have to be informed to secure their consent, after which a formal invitation would be extended to Australia. Japan and the US have taken on the Canberra's inclusion for India and have been pushing India to consider it. The Malabar exercise, which have been delayed this year due to the COVID-19 pandemic, should take place toward the end of 2020. The source said the inclusion of Australia in the exercises would mark a major shift for India's Indo-Pacific plans. The problem of being over-reliant on one revenue stream. U.S. universities, with already limited fiscal space, will now find themselves even further squeezed by the ICE regulations. This article was written by Karthik. The US Immigration and Customs Enforcement regulations regarding student visas have been thrown US-based international students into a turmoil. The regulation adds a new dimension of the pandemic-riddled academy year by denying entry up to students enrolled in the fully online programs and requiring existing student to either switch to campuses with at least one in-person course to risk deportation as disruptive and impactful as this may have been for a student. There is another potentially larger impact that the warrants inspection, the impact on the university finances. Withdrawal of the public fund. The past several decades have seen an ever-increasing relative withdrawal of the public funds from the university global. Even as demand for the higher education across has done, the perception of the college as means to higher income, combined with the emphasis on the competition-driven efficiency, has meant a global trend to replacing college grants with loans and the tuition fee or other private forms of the funding. Proponents of this process have also argued that this helps increase the autonomy of university. This phenomenon has been particularly pronounced in this US. Tuition costs have been steadily rising and a greater share of cost of education is placed on students and their families, with some supplementation by federal, state or private loans. Government watching WHO alert on the airborne spread of virus. We are following the situation closely, as says Health Ministry. Continuing to rule out community transmissions of the COVID-19 in the country, the Union Health Ministry on the Thursday said it is closely watching the dynamic evolution of virus situation in India, with the World Health Organization, WHO, now indicating the virus may be airborne. After earlier denials Daniels, the WHO Tuesday said there will be evidence of emerging of the airborne spread of the coronavirus after 230 scientists across the world asked the global body to update its guidance. We have been talking about the possibility of airborne transmissions and aerosol transmission as one of the modes of the transmission of COVID-19. Maria Van Kerkhove, technical lead on the COVID-19 pandemic at WHO, said. WHO on Tuesday, acknowledging emerging evidence for the airborne of the novel coronavirus, while the previously it has said that the virus spreads only through droplet transmissions. How the explanation differ? Droplet transmission, number one, it occurs when a person is within 1 meter of the infector who coughs or sneezes and so exposing their mouth, nose or eyes to potentially infective respiratory droplets. Such droplets are 5 to 10 micrometers in the diameter, being heavy droplets fall to the floor soon. Airborne transmission, it refers to transmissions by aerosol, smaller droplets less than 5 micrometers, which can linger in the air of the longer periods before falling to the floor and can be transmitted to others over a distance greater than 1 meter. Aerosol may be get released when infectors breathe heavily, talk or sing loudly. Apart from the coughing and sneezing, aerosol contain fewer viruses or particles than larger droplets. Owing up to the criminalization in politics, the February 2020, the order pushes envelope further and the restricting criminal candidates from the contesting election. February 2020, Supreme Court judgment on the criminalization in politics may be a far-reaching consequences for Indian democracy. It will first be implemented in the coming Bihar election, October 2020, the court has asked the political parties to state reason for such selection as also to why other individuals, whether criminal antecedent, could not be selected as the candidate. If a political party fails to comply, it would be in contempt of this court's order or directions. In other words, the political party and its leadership would be for the first time have to publicly own by the criminalization of politics. They had been denying it all these years. Earlier orders to a state, number one, each candidate shall submit a sworn affidavit giving financial details and criminal cases. B, each candidate shall inform the political party in the writing of the criminal cases against him or her. And C, the party should put up on its website and on social media as well as publish in newspaper the names and details of each candidate. Why did the court pass such an order? The judgment notes that in 2024, 24% of the members of parliament had a criminal case pending against them. 2009, that went to 30%, 2014, 34%, and 2019, as many as 43% of MPs had criminal cases pending against them. India is the only democratic country with a free press where we find a problem of this dimension. Thank you so much to watch my program. Wish you all the best. God bless you. God bless Bharat. Jeevan mein sarvashrestha muskurahat de.